15 super talented wrestlers whose careers were destroyed by Vince McMahon. Originally starting off as a show where up-and-coming talent could showcase their abilities in an attempt to get a contract with the WWE, NXT eventually became a promotion on its own for rising talent, and it's quickly become a force in the wrestling industry. A huge number of today's current superstars made their way through the NXT ranks, and the NXT roster, in its current state, remains stacked full of budding talent. We've seen so many wrestlers come up into the WWE from NXT and make a huge impression on fans from the get-go, but unfortunately, some wrestlers have struggled to find any sort of footing after being called to the main roster. The names on this list are comprised of those wrestlers who had all the promise in the world but have yet to do anything with their immense amount of talent. Whether they're dealing with injuries or a lack of a major push from the powers that be, these superstars have yet to achieve what many fans felt they were destined for. These performers were once red-hot prospects but have since become an afterthought in the minds of fans. Of course, there's always time in a person's career for him or her to make a comeback, so we remain hopeful that, one day, these 15 performers will eventually find the success that we all expected them to gain. Until then, though, they'll remain on this list as some of the biggest NXT call-ups who were squashed by Vince McMahon. 1. Produce Clay. Back before it was considered a developmental promotion for the WWE, NXT was actually a reality series, and it was used too much success to develop the next generation of talent to make their way into the WWE. On the fourth season of NXT, Produce Clay was one of the competitors, and he was talented enough to reach the runner-up position on the series. Unfortunately for Clay, his run in the WWE wasn't indicative of the potential that he possessed, and he accomplished next to nothing inside the confines of the WWE. His biggest achievement in the company was back in 2012, when he won the Slammy Award for Best Dancer of the Year, an award that has nothing to do with his wrestling abilities. Currently, Produce Clay is a free agent after having spent time in TNA, which is now known as Global Force Wrestling, and recently, he made an appearance in the series Glow as the character Mighty Tom Jackson. 2. Summer Rae. Summer Rae currently finds herself in the peculiar position of being a very minor player in what has become a very deep women's division. Much like Dana Brooke, most people seem to think of Summer Rae as an afterthought of a performer, and her career on the main roster has easily been one of the more disappointing ones in recent memory. Let's just put it this way, in 2015, she was voted having the worst storyline of the year, and in 2013, Wrestling Observer Newsletter gave her, along with many other competitors who were in the match, the award for Worst Work Match of the Year. She's perhaps best known for her time on the reality series Total Divas, and that says a whole lot about her as a performer. Injuries have long kept her out of the WWE, and we can't imagine her ever receiving a huge push, especially when the division is stacked with the talent that it currently has. 3. Ty Dillinger. The Perfect 10 hasn't been in the WWE all that long, but at this point, you already kind of have to wonder what the company has in store for Ty Dillinger. In NXT, Dillinger was an incredibly popular performer who's shown on numerous occasions that he's capable of putting on outstanding matches. The 36-year-old has been in the wrestling business for quite a long time now, and we're hoping to see him do big things on the WWE main roster. Dillinger spent over 3 years in NXT harnessing his skills before making his way up to the WWE main roster in January of 2017 during the Royal Rumble. Because he's been in the company less than a year, it may seem a bit controversial to put him on this list, but given the immense amount of talent that he truly has, we're hoping that he doesn't see the same fate as wrestlers like Bo Dallas and Curtis Axel. 4. Dana Brooke. Thanks to developing their skills in NXT for several years, the WWE Women's Division is at its red-hot peak right now, and the divisions on Raw and SmackDown are both full of incredible talent thanks to the hard work of performers like Charlotte Flair, Sasha Banks, and Bayley. Female performers are now taken seriously, and they've been responsible for putting on some of the most entertaining matches over the last 2 years. It seems, however, that lost in the shuffle of immense female talent is performer Dana Brooke. Brooke was in NXT for 3 years, and she proved herself to be a very talented performer. On the main roster, however, the former bodybuilder has achieved very little, and with the current slate of women on the roster improving by leaps and bounds virtually week to week, you have to think that, at some point, Dana Brooke will be little more than a footnote in women's division history. 5. Apollo Crews. From October 2014 to April 2016, Apollo Crews wreaked havoc down in NXT, and at one point, he nearly became champion while taking on Finn Balor. Apollo Crews possesses incredibly rare athleticism found in few WWE superstars, and the year and a half that he's spent in the WWE is definitely considered disappointing by most fans. It's not that Crews doesn't possess the talent to take himself to the next level. It's just that the WWE is chock full of incredible performers that seem to be hindering his growth as a performer. His pairing with Titus O'Neil as his manager was successful at first, but it appears that it'll eventually run its course and wear thin on fans. As it stands now, it doesn't appear that Crews is in line for a decent push, and it seems he'll be relegated to the mid-card for quite some time. The most notable thing that he's done in recent memory is take one of the most vicious bumps so far this year in a match with gargantuan strongman Braun Strowman. 6. Chad Gable. As one half of the tag team American Alpha, wrestler Chad Gable, who despite only being 5'8", has shown a true athletic ability inside the ring. Down in NXT, American Alpha was a one-time NXT tag team champion, and once they finally made their way to the main roster, they would eventually win the WWE SmackDown Tag Team Championship. So, why do we have Gable on this list? Well, based off of what we've seen since their split, it appears that American Alpha was mainly used to get Jason Jordan on the main roster. Comparatively speaking, Jordan is a much larger and more physically imposing wrestler than Chad Gable is, and smaller performers have a very hard time making an impact in the company. Hopefully, Gable gets the push that he truly deserves, but right now, it would seem that the WWE simply used him to help aid in the development of former partner Jason Jordan. 7. The Ascension. Sporting the look that calls back to the wrestling days of old, the Ascension are some of the most physically imposing men in the WWE tag team scene, and expectations were high when they finally made their way up to the main roster. Unfortunately for them, their main roster run wouldn't come close to reaching the level attained by legendary tag team the Road Warriors. Down in NXT, they had reached the pinnacle of the promotion after winning the NXT Tag Team Championship. But since making their way into the WWE in 2014, the Ascension is little more than an afterthought in a tag team scene that boasts the New Day and the incredibly talented pairing of Cesaro and Sheamus. At this point, you truly have to wonder what the WWE's long-term plans are for the Ascension. They're not an overly popular group, so perhaps splitting them up into singles action would be the best choice in the meantime. 8. Adam Rose. At 38 years of age, Adam Rose has been in the professional wrestling scene since 1995 when he made his debut in his native South Africa. In 2010, Rose would make his way into the United States, performing in Florida Championship Wrestling before it was eventually rebranded into NXT Wrestling. Rose was a very talented and popular performer during his time in NXT, though he failed to actually take home any major titles during his extended run with the company. Finally, in 2014, Rose made his way to the WWE main roster, and the several years that he spent with the company were underwhelming, to say the least. He would have eventually seen his release in 2016, and he's subsequently spent the entirety of 2017 performing on the independent scene. Given his age, We can't imagine a scenario in which Rose comes back to the WWE to receive a massive push despite all the years he spent with their developmental brand.